back from the dead, Russian journalist Arkady Babchenko entered a press conference in Kiev to applause, hours after most of the world thought he'd been shot dead. His murder had been faked, a sting operation by Ukraine's Secret Service to apparently catch his would-be killers. Babchenko apologized to all those who'd been kept in the dark, including his wife.
I'd like to ask that you excuse me for all that happened in the past, because I have attended funerals for colleagues and friends many times, and I know this feeling when you have to bury colleagues. Sorry for this. Unfortunately, there were no other ways.
Flowers had been left outside Babchenko's Kiev home, where late on Tuesday evening the journalist was reportedly found with fatal gunshot wounds to the back. Tributes and obituaries mourned his death. But as the secret was revealed live on TV, colleagues at the channel where he worked reacted with joy and tears of relief. Russia has denied any role in the Babchenko story and accused Kiev of using it as propaganda. But Russia is where Ukraine's security chiefs alleged the murder plot originated. Babchenko fled his home country last year after a career as an anti-Putin voice culminated in a state-backed media campaign against him.
We reported that in order to fulfill this cynical plan, special services of the Russian Federation recruited a Ukrainian citizen. The first letter of his name is G. He was commissioned to find perpetrators of this brutal murder for financial reward. In order to fulfill the assignment from the Russian special services, Citizen G offered his acquaintance to commit a terrorist act and to murder Russian journalist Arkady Babchenko for $30,000.
Ukraine's Secret Service, the SBU, showed video, allegedly, of this Citizen G being arrested on Kiev streets. And they say that Babchenko wasn't the only one in danger. 30 more people were being targeted. For journalists working in the Russian-speaking world, there is palpable relief that someone that they had been mourning is actually alive. But amongst some, there is also concern. Concern that in the post-truth age, an era of fake news, a security operation like this, as spectacular as it may be, might further degrade trust in the long run. Rory Challands, Al Jazeera, Moscow.